गुड।
श्रीमोहन
सर, गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग घनश्याम सर। सुनता मैडम, हेलो सुनता मैडम, हाँ पूजा मैडम,
हेलो
हेलो
हेलो हेलो सर, एम आई ऑडिबल?
यू आर ऑडिबल बट आपण माने लैपटॉप आउ मोबाइल एका संगे ऑन करिछन बोले।
सॉरी सॉरी, मोर लैपटॉप रे ना ये नहीं है बात, माने ऑडियोटा नहीं
नहीं आपण कना ऑफिस रे अछन के?
सर, घरे अच्छा।
नहीं इको होचे तो माने केनटा गोटे दुईटा डिवाइस आपन लगेचन कि काना जे सेटा
सर
देखवाले
केंटा
पड़ो।
करी करनी, एक्चुअली आई डोंट नो कि हाउ टू क्लिक दैट ऑडियो ऑप्शन इन लैपटॉप।
नहीं एबे ठीक अछे, एबे एबे ठीक आसला, तो फास्ट इको होतला।
एबे ठीक अछि सर,
हाँ एबे ठीक अछे। पूजा मैडम,
बट स्टिल मते इको हुजे
हाँ हमको टिकट टिक सुबुचे जे
लैपटॉप रे सर केंटा करी क्लिक करनी, जे तो मते प्रेजेंटेशन टा शेयर करवार अछि, सेति लागि मैं पठाउ छी।
देखुन जदि पूजा मैडम से शेयर कर पारबे देन पूजा मैडम से शेयर करथुबे आपन ये करबे।
नो सर, एक्चुअली लैपटॉप रे माने से ऑडियो ऑप्शन टा क्लिक नहीं है बार।
नहीं ठीक अच्छे आपन मोबाइल रु ये करूँ ऑडियो ये के टोटल म्यूट कर दो लैपटॉप रे, है ना? मो लैपटॉप रे ऑडियो ऑप्शन पूरा म्यूट कर दो, आपन पूरा टोटल वॉइस आ देबे मोबाइल थ्रू रे, है ना? हाँ पूजा मैडम स्टार्ट स्टार्ट कर दे बोले भले था।
यस सर, यस सर।
Good morning, everyone. So, our resource person is here. She is Sunita Mishra from Odisha State Open University. She has started her presentation. But before her technical arrangement, let me introduce you with the topic, which is production. As we have completed the first module, which is the consumption part of economics, and now we will move on to the production part. Then we will go to the distribution and then the allocation. So, since we have first completed the consumption function and the consumption part of economics, we will now move on to production. Consumption, which is the destruction of utility of a commodity. Now we will read about the creation of the utility of a commodity. That how the production takes place, why is it important, what are the various factors that are influential for production, what are required for production. All those things and all those ideas that would be presented to us by our resource person today. And she will give us a brief idea about why do the firms even produce commodities and what is the need for production. And we will have a good idea about what is cost and why is it important for a farm or a producer or even a consumer to know about the cost of a commodity. Okay, so if the resource person is ready, we will start. Hello?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Shall we start?
Okay. Ma'am? Yeah. Thank you, Pooja madam. So first of all, I welcome all the learners to this session. And as she introduces that today's session is basically on production, cost, and production and cost analysis both, and also optimal allocation of resources and optimal production of output. So before entering into the main core course, we must know that what are the concepts and what are the structure of this session. So here we first of all discuss production, then different concepts relating to production like production function, types of production function, then what are the properties of production function, then what are the main concepts relating to production function and what is the efficient range of production function, then production function in the short period, production function in long period, again production function with one variable input or one input and production function with two inputs. After that we will switch over to cost and cost analysis. So first we'll start from production. So here the concept is production. So first of all, I would like to ask that what do you mean by production? What is the meaning of production? Because that production word is not a typical word. It's a very common word. Everyone know that, or everyone in her day-to-day language using that, producing this, producing that, production of this, production of that. So what does this production mean? Anybody can answer this question in the chat box, please. Okay, so here I say that production is nothing but production means, or production may be defined as the transformation of inputs into output. So I must share the presentation that I prepare. So it is visible to all?
Hello? No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
It is not visible. Just a minute. I am sharing. Just a minute. Just a minute, sir. Just a minute. Now is it visible?
No, ma'am.
Okay.
Sunita madam, if you find difficulty in sharing, is it ready?
Hello.
यस मैम
हेलो सुनता मैडम
यस सर यस
सर आपन जदि जतले लैपटॉप लगाउछन इको होउछ
अच्छा सर
हाँ एबे ठीक अच्छे हाँ एबे ठीक अच्छे जदि आपन कर टिके हेलो
यस
जदि आपन कर टिके डिफिकल्टी होउछे शेयरिंग करबा ले ताले पूजा मैडम के दे दूं छे सेनु शेयर करबे
यस सर यस सर
जदि होउछ जदि आपन को शेयरिंग होउछ त ठीक
सर सर एबे तो विजिबल अछे
विजिबल अछे त ठीक अछे प्लीज
ओके सर इको होउछ कि इको होउछ कि
नहीं
इको होनी तो
नहीं
ओके सो ओके लेट्स स्टार्ट द कांसेप्ट इज व्हाट इज प्रोडक्शन सो आई सेड
मैडम होउछ
इको होउछ मैडम
इको होउछ
तो पूजा मैडम आर यू इन अ कंफर्टेबल पोजीशन टू शेयर इट
यस सर आई एम इन ऑफिस ओनली
हां तो मैडम बेटर हवा ताको तो मेल कर देबे
ओके जस्ट अ मिनट मैं सांगे सांगे मेल करूचे
ओके
ओके
विद इन दैट पीरियड आई मे रिक्वेस्ट पूजा मैडम टू शेयर समथिंग अबाउट प्रोडक्शन एंड ऑल दोस थिंग्स
ओके सर सिंस वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद प्रोडक्शन व्हाट इज प्रोडक्शन आई हैव टोल्ड यू इट इज द क्रिएशन ऑफ यूटिलिटी इन अ कमोडिटी इट मींस means production of a commodity leads to creating utility in it whereas consumption leads to destruction of utility consumption is generally a consumer behavior whereas production is related to the producers only okay being managers it is important for all of you to know how the farm produces okay so what are the important factors which are related to the production and why is it production necessary for all of you okay then what is the concept of production there are certain important aspects that we all need to know what is long run how is time period important for production these are the various concepts that would that we will get to know in this class okay then I know there are certain theories that are related to time period and how does production differs in short run as well as long run what is short run we will know the concept of short run and long run and how it is influential or how does it determines the farm's future present and what are all those things that are related means how is the past of a farm also important in the production process okay then these are the various aspects that we would learn from this presentation or this class and this counseling session since this would be the second most important unit in economics okay ma'am
I send it so Pooja ma'am please share it
okay
okay so sorry for this interruption I'm very sorry so now we start so what I'm talking about is what is production so production is defined as transformation of inputs into output so here the thing is that transformation of inputs two words comes that inputs and output so these two words in the concept of production or in this definition of production is the important one because this input and output is the main thing which define or through which production is defined so before entering into the concepts of what is input and what is output I must share with you one example suppose production of wheat when we are considering production of wheat so how wheat is produced for the product for producing wheat certain amount of things are required what are they labor capital land etc so here when certain amount of labor and capital applied into the land then we get a end product which we called as output and the end product is nothing but the wheat so here the terms that are combined to produce the end product wheat is known as the inputs and the end product or the total
or the last result of the combination of input is known as output. So in this example, labor, land, capital, all these things are considered as input, and wheat, which is the end result of the combination of this input, is known as output. So here I think it is clear to all of you that what is input and what is output. Then another
sorry
important
to interrupt, ma'am.
Yes?
Is the screen visible now?
No, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Present now go apan click karun. Click karle ka apan setting dekhebo.
Okay.
Present now go click karle ta photo screen go asbo. Sei apan click karle ta set option asbo. Sei go apan click karle apan go screen ame dekhi paribo. Yes, ma'am, now it's visible.
Okay.
Now the photo se dekhun to hide bol likha aiche sei hide go click kar diun.
हाइट को क्लिक कर दो
हां वो फुल स्क्रीन भी कर दियो
हां और F5 को क्लिक करने फुल स्क्रीन है वो F5 यस मैम
ओके थैंक यू
ओके शैल आई स्टार्ट
यस मैम
ओके सो अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग टू बी कंसीडर्ड हियर इज दैट Here, wheat is a thing, or it is a physical thing which we can see, which we can touch, but it doesn't mean that production refers only to physical things like wheat, cloth, etc., the products that we can touch or we can see. But production also refers to the production of services. Suppose a doctor's treatment to his patient, or when a teacher teaches to his student, or when a musician singing, that all these things are not visible, not we cannot touch it, but these are also known as production of services. So in production, the physical things are not only included, but services are also included. So with this, we move on to the two things. First one is input and the second one is output. So as we know that the things that are required to produce the end result are known as inputs. So again, input again classified into two kinds. One is fixed input and the other one is variable input. So what do you mean by fixed input? Fixed input means the input whose quantity remains the same in the whole process of production. For example, jemteki suppose it is I am taking the same example, that is the production of wheat. Jetebele gote land ame utilize karuchu to produce a crop or something else or any commodity or any product, then sethire jo land utilize hochi seta kon sange sange change hei paribo ki? No, it cannot change, because land or building or machinery, a type for inputs change hoba pe it requires a particular time, it requires some time. So within the short period of time, we cannot these inputs to be changed. So when the inputs remain same in the whole process of production for a particular period of time, then we call such input as fixed input. For example, land, for example, capital. जदि आमे गोटे बिजनेस स्टार्ट करूचे कि गोटे प्रोडक्शन एक्टिविटी स्टार्ट करूचे तो सेथिरे जो कैपिटलटा आमे इन्वेस्ट करूचु से इन्वेस्टमेंटटा को चेंज करिबा पई वी मस्ट नीड अ टाइम सो विद इन शॉर्ट पीरियड ऑफ टाइम वी कैन नॉट चेंज सो दैट्स व्हाई फिक्स्ड इनपुट मींस द इनपुट्स होस क्वांटिटी रिमेन द सेम इन द होल प्रोसेस ऑफ प्रोडक्शन देन नेक्स्ट कम टू वेरिएबल इनपुट्स व्हाट आर दिस वेरिएबल इनपुट्स वेरिएबल इनपुट्स मींस जेतेबेले व्हीट रो प्रोडक्शन लागि आमे लैंड यूटिलाइज करले तो लैंड यूज होची कैपिटल यूज होची बट फार्मर्स रिक्वायर्ड टू कल्टीवेट इन द फील्ड से फील्ड रे काम करिवा पे लेबरर दरकार पडंती आ लेबरर अकॉर्डिंग टू टाइम अकॉर्डिंग टू रिक्वायरमेंट वी कैन चेंज स्टार्टिंग रे केही नथिबे देन वी कैन इंक्रीज द लेबरर्स और फार्मर्स 1 2 3 इन दिस वे वी कैन वेरी द amount of inputs. So the inputs which vary with the level of output or with the requirement of the output, these inputs are known as variable inputs. For example, labor. Jete bele jo input ku ame within the short period of time taku ame change kari pariba according to the requirement of output or according to the level of output, then we say such inputs are known as variable inputs. Okay, I think it is clear to all of you. So next we proceed, and that is production, that is output. First point in the production definition is input, and the next point is output. So what is output? In a simple term, we can say the end result is known as output. When we combining something, some inputs, and then the end result is known as the output. The end result is known as the product. So the product or output refers to the total amount of goods produced, the total volume of goods produced by a firm by combining all the inputs during a particular period of time or a given period of time. And when we consider a given period of time, here we can see the output from three different angles. It means the output is nothing but it is the product. So it is the total product. Then another thing, we can consider it from another angle, that is average product, and another thing is that marginal product. So output can be seen from three different angles. First is total product, second one is average product, third one is marginal product. So what is this total product? Total product is the simply the total volume of goods and services produced by combining all the inputs during a specified period of time. Then come to the average product. What is this average product? So per unit output production of a variable factor. Why here variable factor is taken? Because jete bale ame land nouchu ki capital nouchu, so main kamota kie kore? Main kamota variable factor hi kore. Tama pakre machinery achi, tama pakre buildings achi, tama pakre plant achi, but you don't have labor or workers, then who run the machinery? So here, that's why the output production is depends mainly on the variable factor, because it is the variable factor that run the machineries. So that's why the average product or average product is considered from the variable factor. So here average product can be calculated or can be obtained by dividing total product and labor. It means gote labor kete output douchi, mane gote labor how much he is producing. So per unit production of a variable factor. So jodi gote factory re ame 10 laborer employ kale, to per laborer head re kete unit of output production rahila, gote labor kete output produce karuche, that is the per unit production of a variable factor. So it is clear to all of you. Please respond, dear learners, please respond in the chat box. Okay.
Hello.
So here,
what?
Yes.
Hello.
Ma'am,
what are the variable factors? What are the variable factor here?
Here variable factor is labor. Jota ame short period of time re change kari pariba, tame raw materials change kari paribo according to the need of the output. Suppose tamko output badhebar achi to tame sei hisab re raw materials change karibo, laborers change karibo, kintu land hela jota fixed inputs like land, buildings, machinery, eguda ko short period of time re not possible to change. That's why it is considered as fixed factor, and raw materials, laborers, all these are considered as variable factors. Okay, so so then next is marginal product. So here I clear that marginal, it means very small. Marginal means very small. When marginal added to anything, then it defines the small change in that particular thing. So here marginal is added to product, it means small change in total product. So marginal product means when we change the variable factor one unit more or one unit less. What is the change in the total product? Jodi ame gote unit of variable factor ku bodhile, किंबा गोटे यूनिट ऑफ वेरिएबल फैक्टर को कमेले ताहले टोटल प्रोडक्ट रे कौन चेंज आसीबो. सो इटे अगेन द क्वेश्चन अराइज दैट व्हाई वन यूनिट, एज आई सेड मार्जिनल, मार्जिनल मीन्स वेरी स्मॉल, वेरी स्मॉल. सो वेरी स्मॉल हियर इज वन यूनिट. ओके, सो जेतेबेले आमे सपोज फॉर एग्जांपल हियर आई एम गिव यू वन एग्जांपल दैट सपोज देर आर 10 लेबर्स एंड 20 यूनिट ऑफ आउटपुट इज टू बी प्रोड्यूस्ड. 10 लेबर्स 20 यूनिट ऑफ आउटपुट इज टू बी प्रोड्यूस्ड. इफ द फार्म विल इंक्रीज द लेबर एम्प्लॉयड बाय वन यूनिट मोर, इट मीन्स 20 प्लस 1 21, देन व्हाट वुड बी द चेंज इन द टोटल प्रोडक्ट दैट इज 20 यूनिट्स ऑफ आउटपुट. 20 यूनिट ऑफ आउटपुट रे केते इंक्रीमेंट हबो जदि आमे वन यूनिट लेबर को एम्प्लॉयमेंट आउ दबा किंबा वन यूनिट लेस एम्प्लॉयड, लेस एम्प्लॉयमेंट दबा मीन्स वन यूनिट डिडक्ट करदबा ताहले आउटपुट रे कौन चेंजेस आसीबो. सो दैट स्मॉल चेंज इज द मार्जिनल प्रोडक्ट. सो दैट्स व्हाई हियर इट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड दैट मार्जिनल प्रोडक्ट इज नथिंग बट द चेंज इन द टोटल प्रोडक्ट दैट इज रिजल्टिंग फ्रॉम वन यूनिट मोर और वन यूनिट लेस ऑफ द वेरिएबल फैक्टर. Or mathematically, that is del TP by del L. It means change in total product divided by change in labor or the variable factor. Here we taken labor as the variable factor. So that's why change in L. Then these are the two terms that is involved in production. Then we move to production function. All what we discussed now is about production. Now, how we represent this production, how we represent the combination of inputs to produce a particular or given level of output, how we represent. So the representation of production or combination of inputs is known as production function, or in other words, we can say a functional relationship between quantities of physical input and physical output is known as production function. So how it will be represented? It can be represented in various ways, either through a graph or schedule or through an equation also. So first of all, here I am presenting through an equation that Y. Here Y is nothing but output. Here Y is nothing but taken as output. Y is a function of. It means the output depends on. That's why function of. L, K, R, S, E. L means labor, K means capital, R means land. Sorry, here it is wrongly written, not land, it is raw material only. S is represented as land, E for entrepreneurship. So these are the symbols that are represented different factor inputs. So here Y representing output, L representing labor, K representing capital, R representing raw materials, S representing land and entrepreneurs. And there are so many factor inputs, but for simplicity, I am taking this much. Again, all these factor inputs depend upon technology. With the presence of technology, when these inputs combined, then the end result is known as the output, and the presentation of such an combination of inputs and output is known as production function. Now, when the technology advanced or with the improvement of technology, the two concepts come to our mind, that is, one is more can be produced with the same inputs or same can be produced with the less input. So first point is more can be produced. Mane tamko inputs given thibo. Jitki inputs diya hai chi. Suppose 10 unit of capital. For simplicity, I am taking only two factor inputs, that is land and labor and capital. Okay, labor and capital. If 10 units of labor are given and 5 units of capital are given, with this given inputs, more output can be produced with the advancement in technology. This is the first point. And the next point to be considered is with less input, same can be produced. It means suppose the level of output is given to us, means we cannot change the level of output, but we can reduce the consumption, we can reduce the employment of factor inputs. We can reduce the factor consumption. Okay, so with less inputs, how more output can be produced? With less inputs, how the same output can be produced? Or with the same inputs, how more output can be produced? So this represents the production function. Then next, as I am said, that production function, previously what I discussed is, I represent the production function through an equation, and this production function can also be presented with the help of a graphic or with the help of diagram. So the graphic presentation of production function is known as isoquant. The graphic presentation of production function is known as isoquant. So here, isoquant, in this term, iso, the term iso come from Greek word which means equal or same, which means equal or same. Now question comes that what is this isoquant represents? So as it is used in the production function, so a production isoquant represents the different combination of inputs which is capable of producing a given level of output. Means by combining the outputs differently, here we mean, suppose, here I'm taking an example, suppose 5 units of output can be produced, or 5 unit of output to be produced, means here the 5 unit of output is given to us, and this 5 unit of output can be produced by 4 options. First, either using 15 units of capital or 2 units of labor, or by using 10 units of capital or 3 units of labor, or by using 5 units of capital or 5 units of labor, or by using 3 units of capital and 7 units of capital, 7 units of labor. So these are 4 different combination of capital and labor inputs to produce 5 units of output. It means 5 unit of output ko produce kariba pai ame ei charita कॉम्बिनेशन भितरु जे कोनोसी कॉम्बिनेशन यूज करले भी सही 5 यूनिट ऑफ आउटपुट प्रोडक्शन होबो. व्हाई? बिकॉज़ हियर इट इज मेंशनड दैट आइसोक्वांट रिप्रेजेंट द डिफरेंट कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ इनपुट्स व्हिच इज कैपेबल ऑफ प्रोड्यूसिंग द गिवन लेवल ऑफ आउटपुट. सो 5 यूनिट ऑफ आउटपुट होची गिवन, एंड ऑल द 4 पॉइंट्स दैट आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड हियर नाउ, दीज आर द डिफरेंट कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ इनपुट्स. एई चारिटा कॉम्बिनेशन को यूज करिकी आमे 5 यूनिट ऑफ आउटपुट प्रोड्यूस करि परबा. एंड सच, एंड आफ्टर जॉइनिंग द 4 डिफरेंट पॉइंट वी गेट अ कर्व दैट इज नोन एज आइसोक्वांट और इक्वल प्रोडक्ट कर्व or iso product curve or iso quant. So that is presented in a diagram also. See, so here this is the diagrammatic presentation of production iso quant. 4 different combination of inputs are capable of producing the 5 units of output, and in this diagram the x axis measuring the labor input and y axis measuring the x-axis measuring the labor input, y-axis measuring the capital inputs. So here it representing the isoquant. Then we must discuss that this isoquant have some different properties. Isoquant have possessing some different properties. In this diagram, there are 3 isoquants. 3 isoquants or 3 equal product curves. So a group of isoquant, when more than one isoquant or one equal product curve is there, or we can say a group of isoquant is known as isoquant map. Then higher level of isoquant represents higher level of output. Higher level of isoquant represents higher level of output. It means what? Just see here that the lower, that is Q1 representing 10 units of output, then Q2 isoquant representing 15 units of output, and Q3 representing 20 units of output. So why it is said that higher level of output representing higher level of output? Because here the isoquant Q1, this curve can be drawn by using different points, and those points representing different combination of inputs, that is capital and labor. So here for Q1, K1, L1, then again another point K1, K2, L2, another point K0, L0. When all the three points we join, then we get this curve Q1. Similarly, to get another isoquant, we must take higher level of capital and higher level of labor. So more amount of capital and more amount of labor is required to produce higher amount of output, and accordingly the different combination of inputs again represented through a curve, that is Q2. So in this way, higher level of isoquant represents higher level of output. So this is one of the most important property of an isoquant, that higher level of isoquants represent higher level of output. Then another property is that no two isoquants can intersect each other. If these two isoquants intersect each other, then what will happen? So intersection means the equalization. Intersection means the equality between the two isoquants. So if the two isoquants intersect, it means the two isoquants equal to each other. And if both the isoquants are equal to each other, then Q1 is also present. Producing 10 units of output, and Q2 is also producing 10 units of output. So here the property that higher level of isoquant represent higher level of output is falsified. So that's why no two isoquant can intersect each other. So this is the second property of an isoquant. Then another important property is that isoquants are negatively sloped and convex to the origin. Negatively sloped and convex to the origin, it means here as we move on towards the x-axis, then we are sacrificing capital and we are employing more of labor. We are sacrificing capital and we are sacrificing more of labor inputs to produce the same level of output. That's why the slope, it means we are diminishing the input used, that is capital, and increasing the other input, that is labor. So that's why it is negatively sloped. There is negative relationship between the capital and labor. I mean, as we are employing more labor, then we are reducing the employment of capital. That's why isoquants are negatively sloped and convex to the origin. And why it is convex to the origin, we discuss in the next slide. That depends on its slope of the isoquant. So what is that slope of isoquant and how it is calculated, that we will discuss in the next slide. But before that, so another important property is that no isoquant can touch either axis. Not this isoquant will touch the x-axis, or not the isoquant will touch the y-axis. This is the another property of an isoquant. So in general, we can say that isoquant or equal product curve are determined by specifying a particular level of output, say Q0, and it is represented through a production function, that is Q0 is a function of capital and labor. Okay, I think it is clear to all of you that what is isoquant and what are the properties of isoquant. So next we move to marginal rate of technical substitution. So here another concept, that marginal rate of technical substitution. Substitution means what? Substitution means using one thing in place of one. So here marginal rate of technical substitution. So technical substitution means when we are substituting one factor input in place of another factor input, then it is known as technical substitution. So what is this marginal rate of technical substitution? So this marginal rate of technical substitution refers to the rate at which factors can be substituted at the margin without altering the level of output. Means, in a simpler language, if we say, then what is this marginal rate of technical substitution? this marginal rate of technical substitution represents that when we are substituting one input or we are sacrificing one input. For example, here we are taking capital and labor as the two inputs. So, marginal rate of technical substitution of factor capital for factor labor may be defined as the amount of capital can be the amount of labor can be replaced by one unit of another factor, that is capital, but the level of output remaining unchanged. Mane output level change hobani. Only we are changing the units of input. Capital, for example, it is a numeric example through remo explain koribi. Let's see. Suppose in this diagram, three points are there: A, B, and C. So A represent what? A represent hochi combination of factor input. What combination of factor input? 8 units of capital and 2 units of labor. Clear? A point representing 8 unit of capital and 2 units of labor to produce 10 unit of output. Again, B point representing 4 unit of capital and 4 unit of labor. So, ebe kon hela? Jete bele A ru B ku shift hele. A ru jete bele B ku shift hele. Then what happen? The amount of capital reduces, but the amount of labor increases. The amount of capital reduces, but the amount of labor increases. So, at point B, we will measure at point B, we measure the marginal rate of technical substitution between two inputs, that is capital and labor, that is equals to change in capital and change in labor. So, ethi kono change hela, kete change hela capital le? Aguru 8 unit use karu thile, kintu B point re 4 unit of capital hela. So, 4 minus 8 is representing change in capital. Divided by change in labor, aguru 2 units of labor use karu thile, but B point re 4 unit of labor increase hala, it means change hoji 4 minus 2, that equals to 4 divided by minus 4 divided by 2, that equals to minus 2, or we take the mod value, we take the modulus value here 2. Equalize the negative sign or to normalize the negative sign. Here we are taking mod value. So in this way, when we are moving from point A to point B, some amount of capital is reduced to employ more units of labor. So this is known as marginal rate of technical substitution between capital and labor. So in the same process, when we are moving downward towards the x-axis or towards point C, then the amount of capital sacrificed is diminished. Diminished in the means lower down. First it is 8 units of capital, first it is 8, then it is 4, then it is 2. That's why the slope is diminishing. It means the isoquant is negatively sloped and convex to the origin. So here marginal rate of technical substitution, another important point relating to marginal rate of technical substitution is that it is related to marginal productivity of capital and marginal productivity of labor. So marginal productivity of capital is MPK and marginal productivity of labor is MPL. So what is this marginal productivity of labor and marginal productivity of labor capital? Gote unit labor kitte production douche, that is the productivity of labor. And marginal, why? Marginal means per unit production. Similarly, one unit or per unit capital, what amount of output is produced. So that is the marginal productivity of capital. So how a marginal rate of technical substitution is related with the MPK and MPL? That is, change in labor जिते अमाउंट ऑफ आमे लेबर चेंज कले और तार प्रोडक्टिविटी दैट इज एमपीएल इज इक्वल टू चेंज इन कैपिटल जिते अमाउंट ऑफ कैपिटल आमे चेंज कले एंड तार प्रोडक्टिविटी बोथ आर इक्वल हेले ही सेम अमाउंट ऑफ आउटपुट और सेम लेवल ऑफ आउटपुट प्रोड्यूस हबो दैट इज द कंडीशन हियर सो हियर change in labor multiplied marginal productivity of labor equal to change in capital multiplied marginal productivity of capital that equals to change in capital divided by change in labor that equals to MPK by MPL that is marginal productivity of capital by marginal productivity of labor. So in short or in nutshell we can say marginal rate of technical substitution is nothing but the ratio of productivity marginal productivity of capital and marginal productivity of labor so this is the concept regarding marginal rate of technical substitution is it clear to all okay shall we move the next concept is what is the different shape of isoquant What are the different shape of isoquant? In the previous diagram, we see that the shape is convex to the origin, but there are some cases when the shape of the isoquant changes. So, what are those cases? When the inputs used in fixed proportion, when the input used in fixed proportion, then there is no substitutability between the factor inputs no substitutability it means what mane duita jako input dorkar without any one we cannot produce the particular level of output or a given level of output so two inputs must be used in fixed proportions fixed proportion means capital be fixed proportion re jibo au कैपिटल एंड लेबर बोथ आर गोटे तार कम्बिनेशन थी कि गोटे को आ गोटे जगार सब्सटिट्यूट करें प्रोडक्शन करपरबानी इन सच केस द शेप ऑफ द आइसोक्वांट इज राइट एंगल्ड और एल शेप्ड दैट इज शोन इन पैनल वन दैट इज शोन इन पैनल वन राइट एंगल आइसोक्वांट एंड मार्जिनल रेट ऑफ सब्सटिट्यूशन सेठी जीरो थाए व्हाई जीरो कहीं सब्सटिट्यूटेबिलिटी इज जीरो आम सब्सटिट्यूट करपरबानी बोथ आर रिक्वायर्ड इन अ पर्टिकुलर फिक्स्ड प्रोपोर्शन सो दैट्स व्हाई द शेप ऑफ द आइसोक्वांट इज राइट एंगल्ड और एल शेप्ड देन अनदर काइंड ऑफ आइसोक्वांट इज दैट इज व्हेन The two inputs are perfectly substitutable. Perfectly substitutable. It means either खाली लेबर इनपुट को नहीं कि हमें प्रोडक्शन करी पारीबा और पर्टिकुलर आउटपुट प्रोडक्शन करी पारीबा और खाली कैपिटल को नहीं कि भी प्रोडक्शन आउटपुट करी पारीबा. It means the two inputs are perfectly substituted. Perfectly substitutable. गोटे जगह रे आउ गोटे को हमें substitute करी पारीबा. Then the shape of the isoquant is straight line that is shown in Panel 2. The next one is convex isoquant. So convex isoquant, or we can say a smooth convex isoquant. So in this case, or this when there is imperfect substitutability, jodi perfect substitutable hai gala, tahale eta hobo straight line. So that's why here I am mentioning that imperfectly substitutable or continuously substitutable. Mane bar bar ame taku substitute kari parutuba, and then the shape of the isoquant is convex to the origin. Demti ki previously diagram re dekhile. कि एज वी मूव फ्रॉम पॉइंट ए टू पॉइंट बी एंड पॉइंट बी टू पॉइंट सी लेबर इज सब्सटिट्यूटेड इन प्लेस ऑफ कैपिटल सो देयर इज कंटिन्यूअस सब्सटिट्यूटेबली सो द शेप ऑफ द आइसोक्वांट इज कन्वेक्स टू द ओरिजिन सो दीज आर द थ्री टाइप ऑफ शेप ऑफ एन आइसोक्वांट दैट व्हेन देयर इज जीरो सब्सटिट्यूटेबिलिटी बिटवीन द टू फैक्टर इनपुट्स देन द शेप इज राइट एंगल व्हेन देयर इज परफेक्ट सब्सटिट्यूटेबिलिटी देन द शेप ऑफ द आइसोक्वांट इज स्ट्रेट लाइन व्हेन देयर इज इम्परफेक्ट सब्सटिट्यूटेबिलिटी और कंटिन्यूअस सब्सटिट्यूटेबिलिटी देन द आइसोक्वांट इज कन्वेक्स टू द ओरिजिन ओके देन मूव टू द नेक्स्ट थिंग दैट इज types of production function. This is all about production function and the slope of the production function or slope of the isoquant, that is marginal rate of technical substitution between two inputs X and capital and labor. Then type of production function. By considering the time period, here the production function is classified into two kinds, that is short run production function and long run production function. Short run production function is the production function where one factor of production or one factor input is variable and other remaining constant. And this type of production function is known as law of diminishing returns or the law of variable proportions. So as I am said that in the short run production function, one factor of production is variable, one factor of production, at least one factor of production is variable and all other are constant. So for simplicity, I am taking here that Q output is produced by using two factor inputs, that is capital and L, that is labor. So here K bar, in the presentation, it is represented as K bar. It means that capital is fixed and labor is variable. So here capital is constant, but labor is variable. So one factor of production is variable and other is kept constant. So such a production function is known as short run production function. Then the next one is long run production function. In this case, all the factors of production are variable. All the factors of production are variable. It means that if we are taking the same function, same production function, that is Q is a function of capital and labor, or output is a function of capital and labor, means both the factors are variable and long run is a envelope of so many short periods. For example, gote borso kemiti hue, gote borso kichi maso ku nei ki hue. So each month, गोटे गोटे मास होची गोटे गोटे शॉर्ट पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. सिमिलरली लॉन्ग रन इट मीन्स लॉन्ग पीरियड कवरिंग सो मेनी शॉर्ट पीरियड्स. सो इन वन शॉर्ट पीरियड वन फैक्टर ऑफ प्रोडक्शन इज वेरिएबल एंड अदर इज कॉन्स्टेंट. एंड इन द अनदर शॉर्ट पीरियड द अदर फैक्टर इज वेरिएबल एंड द फर्स्ट फैक्टर इज कैप्ट कॉन्स्टेंट. इन दिस वे इन द लॉन्ग पीरियड ऑफ in the long period or in the long run production function, all the factors of production or all factor inputs are variable. And this long run production function is also known as returns to scale. This long run production function is also known as returns to scale. So these are the two kinds of production function. Actually, these are the basic or general idea about the types of production function. Later on, we will discuss on it in a more or in a deep manner. So the next concept is that is production function with one variable input. So production function with one variable input, it means it is nothing but representing or saying the same thing, that is the short run production function. Consider one production function here, that Q is a function of capital and L, labor. So capital K bar, again K bar, it means representing constant capital and L representing the variable input. And here again I am repeating the earlier thing, that is which we discussed in the previous slides, that output can be seen from three angles: total product, average product and marginal product. But the thing to be considered here is that here we discuss the theoretical things with the help of a schedule. Okay, with the help of a schedule. So total product is nothing but the total volume of goods and services produced by using different combination of quantities of input during a specified period of time. Jetebele ame capital and labor ko utilize kariki jo total amount of goods kimba total amount of product pauche, that is the total product. Now average product kono? Per unit of variable factor. Jo bhi variable factor employed hai ji, se variable factor, per unit variable factor, kete output produce karu ji. And how we will get this average product? This average product will be obtained by dividing the total amount of total product divided by the total amount of input used, means total output divided by total level. Okay, total labor, because labor is the variable factor here. Then move to marginal product. Marginal product is the small change in the total product. So change in total product due to change in the variable factor, that is due to change in the labor input, that is the marginal product. So now consider this table. Here the first column representing the number of workers, it means the variable factor or the labor. Then the second column representing total output, total output in 1000 per year, gote borsore kete output produce hochi. Then the next column representing marginal product per unit, mane labor gote unit change hele total product re kete change hochi. And the last unit, the last column representing that average product. So here suppose the number of workers starting from zero or employing from zero, TP, when the labor is zero, then the total product is zero, marginal product is nil, average product is nil. Kahingi ama pakare land achi, ama pakare capital achi, but labor nahi, to se land re kamo ki karibo, se machinery upre kamo ki karibe. So it is the variable factor on the basis of which the total output, the production of total output is decided. Jete bale variable factor combined of a fixed factor sangre, then only we will get the end result or the output. So here when we employed one unit of labor, then suppose the total product is 10. Total product is 10, marginal product is 10, and average product is 10. So what is the formula for average product? That is total output divided by variable, total amount of variable factor or variable input. So here total product is 10 and variable input is 1. So 10 by 1 is equal to 10, and there is no change till now, so marginal product is also 10. Now suppose we change the labor from 1 unit to 2 unit, then the total product increases, that is to from 10 to 28, from 10 to 28. So what is the average product? So here average product is equal to total product or total output divided by the total amount of variable input. So 80 variable input kete achi 2, our total product hochi 28. 28 by 2 is equal to 14, that is the average product. And marginal product kon hobo? Change in total product. So aguru total product kete thila 10 thila, but after employing more one unit of labor, we get total product as 28. 28 minus 10 divided by 2 minus 1. 2 minus 1 hochi change in labor. 28 minus 10 hochi change in total product. So that is 14 by 1, that equal to 14. In this way, we move on and we get the marginal product, the average product, and the total product. But the important thing to be considered here is that the relationship between marginal product, average product, and total product. As the marginal product is increasing, as the marginal product and average product is increasing, then the total product increases at an increasing rate. Total product increases at an increasing rate. Just go through the diagram. See the diagram here. Dekho, first ray, jo lower portion achi diagram ro, in the panel 2, aur tole jo dita curve achi, that is MP curve. Blue line is the MP curve and pink line is the AP curve. So first hochi, MP curve is increasing and AP curve is also increasing. And corresponding to that, the total product curve is upper diagram in panel 1, total product curve is also increasing. So that's why here it is written that when AP rises, MP rises, then total product also rises at an increasing rate. Increasing rate kahin ki kuha gala? Increasing rate ethi pahin kuha gala? Kahin ki other concept or other products, that is average product or marginal product, both are increasing. Both are increasing, and marginal product hoji slope of the total product. So jodi slope increase karuchi, to total product bhi increase karuchi. That's why here it is written that total product rises at an increasing rate. But after a point, when the AP diminishes, AP diminishes, dekho, सेकेंड स्टेज जोटा कहगला सेकेंड स्टेज एपी इज डिमिनिशिंग एंड एमपी रिचेज टू इट्स मैक्सिमम पॉइंट एंड देन इट इज ऑल्सो डिमिनिशिंग सो इन दिस केस कंसिडर द एबोव डायग्राम टोटल प्रोडक्ट इज इंक्रीजिंग आफ्टर पॉइंट एक्स टोटल प्रोडक्ट इज ऑल्सो इंक्रीजिंग बट एट ए डिमिनिशिंग रेट व्हाई डिमिनिशिंग रेट कहीं डिमिनिशिंग रेट जीरो रु एक्स पर्यंत टीपी इंक्रीज करुची एट इंक्रीजिंग रेट किंतु बियॉन्ड एक्स दैट इज फ्रॉम एक्स टू वाई टीपी इंक्रीज करुची एट अ डिमिनिशिंग रेट व्हाई डिमिनिशिंग रेट बिकॉज स्लोप ऑफ टीपी दैट इज स्लोप ऑफ टीपी होची मार्जिनल प्रोडक्ट ऑफ लेबर सेटा डिमिनिश करुची दैट्स व्हाई टोटल प्रोडक्ट इज इंक्रीजिंग बट एट अ डिमिनिशिंग रेट जदि डायग्राम भी जदि हमें टेबल को भी कंसीडर करबा तो टेबल रे भी सेटा होची टोटल प्रोडक्ट 10 28 54 76 कंटीन्यूअसली इंक्रीज करुची मार्जिनल प्रोडक्ट भी 10 18 26 तक इंक्रीज कला देन एवरेज प्रोडक्ट 10 14 18 इंक्रीज कला 18 देन 19 इंक्रीज कला बट आफ्टर दैट मार्जिनल प्रोडक्ट इज फॉलिंग एंड एवरेज प्रोडक्ट इज ऑल्सो फॉलिंग बट स्टिल द टोटल प्रोडक्ट इज इंक्रीजिंग सो हियर दो द मार्जिनल प्रोडक्ट एंड एवरेज प्रोडक्ट इज फॉलिंग बट द टोटल प्रोडक्ट इज इंक्रीजिंग दैट्स वाई इट इज मेन्शन द टोटल प्रोडक्ट इंक्रीजिंग एट एन डिक्रीजिंग रेट दैट इज द सेकेंड स्टेज देन इन द थर्ड स्टेज then in the third stage the marginal product just consider the diagram that the blue line touches the x axis that is at 0.7 it means jodi x axis touch karuchi ta mane mp is 0 and corresponding to that mp just see the above diagram total product just see the total product curve that is from y to z at point z the total product curve or the total product is at its maximum point is at its maximum point is at and beyond that point if we consider to mp then mp is go down the x axis it means it is negative it means mp is negative and total product is going to be declining and a average product still diminishing in the third stage and in the second stage so these are the relationship between total product average product and marginal product now on the basis of behavior of average product marginal product and total product economists have divided the production function into three stages and which we called as law of marginal returns law of diminishing marginal returns or law of variable proportion or short run production function and the law of variable proportion principle is considered in the short run so what the principle says that according to the law of diminishing marginal returns or the law of variable proportion when more and more variable factors are combined with the fixed factor then the total product increases at a increasing rate then increases at a diminishing rate and then after a point means getting its saturation point after a point it will starts declining why declining because at that point mp is negative so on the basis of that the law of variable proportion possessing three steps according to the behavior of mp that is marginal product ap that is average product and tp that is the total product so first stage is known as increasing returns why because it is known as increasing return because ap of the variable factor it means the average product of the variable factor increases throughout this stage jodi ame diagram dekhiba to diagram re it is clearly visible that first stage माने जो फास्ट लाइन अच्छी से आप देखि पारे कि एपी ब्लू लाइन पिंक लाइन कर्व थ्रू आउट द स्टेज इज इंक्रीजिंग सो दैट्स व्हाई फर्स्ट स्टेज इज नोन एज इंक्रीजिंग रिटर्न्स एंड टोटल प्रोडक्ट्स स्लोप दैट इज एमपी इट इज ऑल्सो इंक्रीजिंग सो हियर ऑल द थ्री प्रोडक्ट्स आर इंक्रीजिंग एंड कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग टू एपी एंड एमपी टोटल प्रोडक्ट राइजेस एट एन इंक्रीजिंग रेट देन द सेकेंड स्टेज दैट इज नोन एज the stage of diminishing returns. Why diminishing returns? Because MP and AP both are diminishing, but both are positive, not negative. Both are positive. So at the end of this stage, it means at the end of the second stage, marginal product of the variable factor, that is at 0.7, marginal product of the variable factor at 0.7 is 0. Why 0? Because it is touching to the x-axis, that's why it is 0. Means the slope is 0. So corresponding to that point, total product is at its maximum. Total product is at its maximum. And this stage is all otherwise known as the range of rational production decision. Why? We will discuss it in later slides. Okay, just only remember this thing, that second stage of production or second stage of law of variable proportion is known as the rational production range. Rational production range. Why? Because AP and MP is declining. AP and MP, average product and marginal product of variable factors, are diminishing, but they are positive. Then consider the third stage, that is the stage of negative returns. Stage of negative returns, it means that at this stage, MP of the variable factor is negative during this stage. That's why the third stage is known as stage of negative returns, and corresponding to the negative productivity of the variable factor, total product is declining. So this is all about the law of diminishing marginal returns, or law of variable proportion, or production function with one variable input. Then next come to production function with two variable input. So two variable input, as I said earlier, that long run production function covering so many short run, and in one short run, if capital is fixed and labor is variable, then in the other short run or other short period, capital is variable and labor is fixed. In this way, we can say in the long period of time, all the factors of production are variable. So where the case when we consider two inputs, labor and capital both are variable, then such a production function is known as returns to scale. And returns to scale refers to changes in output as all the factors changes by the same proportion or by the different proportion. So for knowing the thing here, I am representing that suppose this is a production function, that is Q is a function of capital and labor. Suppose a new output is produced by changing, new output is produced, that is Q star, by changing both capital and labor by T amounts. Both capital and labor by T amount. So T amount of output is changed with T amount of capital and labor. And that star is representing N, then here again we consider three stages, that is one is constant returns to scale, decrease, and then second one is decreasing returns to scale, and third one is increasing returns to scale. So constant returns to scale, it means T star Q. So T star Q means what? That star representing N, and N represents N is equal to 1. So what does it mean? If Q star increase by the same proportion as the inputs, then the stage is known as constant returns to scale. Ta mane kono? Jodi nua output, mane new level of output jodi increase karuchi, kete amount re increase karuchi? Jetiki amount re inputs increase kala, sei amount re jodi output bhi same proportion re increase karuchi, then to symbolize it, we represent N is equal to 1, and such N is equal to 1 is known as constant returns to scale. Constant returns to scale, it means jetiki amount re inputs change hoche, same proportion re output bhi change hoche. Then next hoche, if आउटपुट इंक्रीज लेस देन प्रोपोर्शनालिटी विथ द इनपुट्स जेतिकी अमाउंट रे इनपुट इंक्रीज होउचे सेतिकी अमाउंट रे आउटपुट प्रोडक्शन होउनी ताहाले दैट स्टेज इज नोन एज डिक्रीजिंग रिटर्न्स टू स्केल इन द लॉन्ग पीरियड ऑफ टाइम एंड दैट कैन बी रिप्रेजेंटेड एन इज लेस देन वन एन इज लेस देन वन थर्डली दैट इज इफ जेतिकी इनपुट्स यूज्ड होउचे टू प्रोड्यूस अ न्यू लेवल ऑफ आउटपुट एंड आउटपुट प्रोपोर्शनली बेसी होउची बेसी प्रोडक्शन होउची विथ रिलेशन टू चेंज इन इनपुट्स देन सच अ स्टेज इज नोन एज इंक्रीजिंग रिटर्न्स टू स्केल एंड इट कैन बी रिप्रेजेंटेड एज एन इज ग्रेटर देन वन एन इज ग्रेटर देन वन सो इट कैन ऑल्सो बी एक्सप्लेन्ड थ्रू ग्राफिकली सो ग्राफिकली हियर थ्री curves are presented or three panel of diagrams are represented here so first one is first panel shows that is constant returns to scale so what how we can explain that it is a constant returns to scale just consider the diagram here there are three isoquants are drawn in the graph three isoquants a b c 50 100 and 150 as higher level of isoquants representing higher level of output But just consider the difference between the isoquants A, B, B, C. Say, भितरे जो difference अच्छी space difference that difference is constant. It means the successive distance between the isoquant is constant. It means that when we double the factor inputs, then the level of initial output doubles and so on. जेते बड़े आमे A रे जेते की amount of first A point रे जेते की amount of capital and labor input used करी की 50 units of output produce करू थिले, जदी आमे सही factor inputs को double कर देले, 1K and 1L को जदी 2K and 2L कर देले, it means 2 units of capital and 2 units of labor, double कर देले, तो double कर देले means तरा output भी double हेगेला 100, सेम बी पॉइंट रे जेते की यूज करूथले सेटा को जदि आमे डबल कर देले देन अगेन द आउटपुट एट पॉइंट सी आल्सो डबल्स दैट इज 150 फ्रॉम 100 टू इट इज 150 सो इन दिस वे वी मेजर द स्पेस बिटवीन ए बी एंड बी सी इज कांस्टेंट सो इन कांस्टेंट रिटर्न्स टू स्केल इट इज आल्सो रिटन इन बिलो द डायग्राम दैट इज ओ ए इज इक्वल्स टू ए बी इज इक्वल्स टू बी सी सो दिस इज द कांस्टेंट रिटर्न्स टू स्केल देन द सेकेंड पैनल शोज इंक्रीजिंग रिटर्न्स टू स्केल इंक्रीजिंग रिटर्न्स टू स्केल मीन्स वॉट सो द ट्रिक टू रिमेंबर दिस इज दैट व्हेन इट इज इंक्रीजिंग रिटर्न्स टू स्केल इट मीन्स द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन The distance between the consecutive isoquants decreases. देखो, AB रो difference केती की अच्छी, AB A रो B पर्जन्त isoquant रो difference केती की, अब B रो C टू को move कले isoquant रो difference केती की. It means as we move above and above or in the successive isoquants, then the difference between the isoquant it will goes on decreasing or declining. So, this is known as increasing returns to scale. So, declining means कौन? जो टा decline हो जे, माने with less amount of input, more output can be produced. That's why increasing returns to scale. So, OA is greater than AB. AB is greater than BC. So, OA रो अर्थ हो जी, difference between the isoquant OA to OAB टू बी सी इज गोज ऑन डिमिनिशिंग माने लेबर माने फैक्टर इनपुट्स गोज ऑन डिमिनिशिंग बट आउटपुट इज गोइंग ऑन इंक्रीजिंग दैट्स वाई इंक्रीजिंग रिटर्न्स टू स्केल और सिम्बोलिकली वी कैन रिप्रेजेंट इज एन इज ग्रेटर देन वन द लास्ट वन इज दैट डिक्रीजिंग रिटर्न्स टू स्केल सो इन डिक्रीजिंग रिटर्न्स टू स्केल इन द फिगर द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन कंजिक्यूटिव मल्टीपल आइसोक्वांट्स इंक्रीजेस जो डिफरेंस अच्छी ओ ए रु ए बी रु बी सी से बढ़ी बढ़ी जीव से डिफरेन्सटा तार बढ़ी बढ़ी जीव दैट इज ओ ए इज लेस देन ए बी इज लेस देन बी सी So it means here the difference, consecutive difference is going on increasing, or in other words we can say when we double the inputs the output will increase. So jo distance ta increase hochi seta hochi due to change in the factor inputs. Ame factor inputs adhika badhauche sethi pai bolikre differences badhuchi but output kamuchi. And previous case re kon hoitla jo amount of factor inputs ame kom badhauthile but in output ta बेसी इंक्रीज करूथला. सो दैट्स व्हाई इट इज इंक्रीजिंग रिटर्न्स टू स्केल. एंड फर्स्ट वन रे हितला डिफरेंस बिटवीन द आइसो क्वांट इज सेम, ता माने ए पॉइंट रे जति की इनपुट्स यूज करूथले जस्ट ताको डबल कले बी पॉइंट रे, देन अगेन ताको डबल कले सी पॉइंट रे, सो द आउटपुट इज आल्सो डबल एंड डबल एंड डबल, माने जति की इनपुट बढुचे सेति की आउटपुट बढुचे. सो दिस इज all about returns to scale or the long run production function or the production function with two variable inputs. Then here question comes that economic reason of production. Economic reason of production means what? In the short run production function, or while explaining the law of variable proportion, I said that the second stage of production represents the efficient range of production or the rational range of production. So why this rational range of production, or what is this rational range of production, or what is this efficient range of production? Efficiency, it means optimally. Optimally it means when we are taking decision, then optimally take by taking into consideration the cost or taking into consideration the benefit from that decision. जत्ते बड़े हमें कौनों से decision नोचे, तो सबूत रे हमें first कौन रखुजे कि कित्ते अधिका benefit हबो और कित्ते कम loss हबो. So that is the rational decision. That is the rational. Similarly, when we apply this idea into production, then it is known as the rational production decision. So here we talk about efficient range of production. Efficient range of production, it means the range where marginal product of the factors are declining but positive. Marginal product of the factors are declining but positive, and this condition is satisfied at the second stage of law of variable proportion. That's why at that time I am saying that the second stage of law of variable proportion represents the range of rational production decision. Just consider this diagram. In this diagram, the x-axis representing the labor input, y-axis representing the capital input, and two curves are here, that is OA. OA curve will be, we get the OA curve by joining the different points of different isoquants. So here three isoquants are represented, and the OA line represent, or the OA curve represent, the marginal, the capital side, or above the OA curve, the marginal productivity of capital is negative. Why negative? Because at this point, means above the OA curve, the isoquant, if we draw a tangent at each point, and then we get that the slope is zero. The slope is zero, and beyond that, if we go beyond that, then the slope is negative. That's why it is said here that above OA, the marginal product of capital is negative, though the y-axis measuring the capital input, and below OB, marginal product of labor is negative, though it is measuring the labor inputs. So in between these two curves, in between OA curve and OV curve, the marginal product of capital and marginal product of labor is positive as well as declining. So the in between range of OA and OB curve represents the economically efficient or economic region of production. Economically efficient or the efficient range of production. And here these two lines, OA line and OB line, representing the ridge line. The name of these lines are known as ridge lines. And this ridge line represents what? The ridge line represents the locus of points. It is nothing but the locus of points of isoquants where the marginal product of factors are zero. Where the marginal product of the factors are zero. So upper ridge line representing the marginal product of upper ridge line representing the marginal product of capital is zero, and the lower ridge line representing the marginal product of labor is zero. So efficient range of production is in between the ridge lines, that is OA and OB. Okay, then next, move to the optimal combination of inputs. Optimal combination of inputs. What do you mean by optimal combination of inputs? If we talk about different combinations of inputs that will resulting in a particular level of output, or employ a particular or produce a particular amount or given amount of output, then we say that all combinations are technically efficient. But the final decision to employ a particular input combination is rests on cost, because cost is the important factor. When a manager decided that what combination of inputs are required to produce a given level of output, he must consider what is the cost on that, because cost is the most important thing to be discussed while taking an efficient decision or economic decision in as far as the outputs are concerned. So cost is the important factor, and on the basis of this, manager have two choices. What are those? First one is either maximum level of output will be produced with the given cost or with the given outlay, or minimum cost of production, or with minimum cost of production a given level of output is to be produced. Ta mane kono na gote cost outlay re, given with the given cost outlay or given outlay re, maximum level of output produce kari paruthiba katha, or with minimum cost of production mane jetti kom cost re jetti ki kom cost hei paribo setiki re gote given amount or given level of output produce karibata. So the manager will choose either two of the option, either one maximum output use karibo with the given cost, or given level of output produce karibo with the minimum cost of production. But before entering into the two choices, we must know one another concept, that is ISO cost line. What is this ISO cost line? The ISO cost line is the locus of all combination of factors the farm can produce with a given monetary cost. So ISO cost line mane kono? ISO cost line means it is, in other words, we can say it is the budget, or this is the expenditure line that is given to the a particular farm. Jemiti ki gote household pakre tar gote budget thai, and accordingly he will spend his money. Semiti gote business farm or gote manager bhi decision niye according to his budget. Ta pakre kete fund achi, according to that fund he will decide that what amount of output is to be produced or how much output is to be produced. So cost line is the expenditure, or it is the constraint towards the manager. By taking care that constraint, the manager will decide that what amount of output is to be produced, and or to produce a given level of output, how the cost will be minimum or minimized. So here the cost line represents all the combination of factors that a farm can purchase with a given monetary cost. Means gote farm jete jo factor input ko hire karuche, se factor input pai jo rewards diya hoche kimba jo monetary cost pay karuche, combining all those costs we will get the ISO cost line. For example, or for simplicity, here two inputs, capital and labor, are taken. So price of capital is represented as PK and price of labor is represented as PL. It means PK and PL is the price of two factor inputs, capital and labor respectively. Then total expenditure. So the total expenditure means the total cost or the total outlay is equal to price of capital into total amount of capital plus price of labor into total amount of labor that is used by the farm. So it will, so this give the total expenditure or total cost function of the farm, total cost function of the farm. Then, so here just consider the diagram. In the diagram it is mentioned that x-axis measuring the price of labor and y-axis measuring the capital. So here at point A and at point B, these are the two extreme points. At point A, what we get? At point A, if the farm is only purchasing capital, only purchasing capital, it means labor input is zero, and only purchasing capital means the share of capital in the among with the total output is what? That is TC or C by PK, C by price of capital, that is shown by point A. Similarly, if the farm is only purchasing the labor and not at all the capital, it means the total amount of capital available to farm A, farm is zero capital, and labor that is available to the farm is C by PL, that is shown by point E, shown by point B. If we join the two points A and B, if we join the extreme two points, then we get a straight line, and such a straight line is nothing but it is the isocost line or the equal cost line, which represents the expenditure line of the farm, the cost line of the farm. And the slope of this isocost line, the slope of this isocost line is equal to the ratio of prices of factors of production. Prices of factors of production means what? PK and PL. Price of capital is PK, price of labor is PL. So to get slope, here we dividing the ratio at point, what we get at point A and what we get at point B, that is C by PK divided by C by PL, that equals to PK by PL, that is price of capital and price of labor. So this is the slope of isocost line or equal cost line. Now, after knowing the budget, after knowing the constraint of the farm, or after knowing the iso, after knowing the cost limit or the expenditure limit of the farm, what would be the optimal combination of inputs? So here the optimal combination of inputs means it is the condition for efficient production. So what is the condition for efficient production? The condition for efficient production is that the isoquant must be tangential to the isocost line. The isoquant must be tangential to the isocost line. And in the diagram, that isoquant giving that 100 units of output is tangential to the isocost line, that is at point Q. So Q is the optimal combination of inputs where OK1 amount of capital is used and OL1 amount of labor is used respectively to produce 100 units of output. And here the condition, this is the graphic representation. If we talk about mathematically, then point Q or the tangency point between the isoquant and the isocost line represents that the slope of isoquant is equal to the slope of isocost line. So the slope of isoquant is what? Isoquant ro slope kothre measure hue? Isoquant ro slope hoji marginal rate of technical substitution, which is equal to the ratio of marginal productivity of labor divided by marginal productivity of capital. And slope of isocost line representing what? That is price of capital is equal to price of labor. So if the slope of isoquant is equal to slope of isocost line, it means that MRTS, marginal rate of technical substitution, is equal to MPL by MPK, that is also equal to the price ratio of labor and capital. So if this condition is satisfied, or if this condition is fulfilled, then the efficient production range is obtained or reached by the farm. So here Q is the efficient production function, or the condition for efficient production function is that the isoquant must be tangential to the isocost line or equal cost line, where the slope of the two curves equal to each other. So this is the optimal combination of inputs. So all the things that is relating to production and production function, different types of production function, all the things are finished here. And if any doubt, then learners can ask question in the chat box. Is there any doubt? Please respond in the chat box. Hello. Hello, am I audible to all of you?
Yes, madam, you are audible. Dear learners, if you have any questions, please unmute your mic and you can ask your question directly to our resource person.
Or shall we move?
Yes, ma'am, you should proceed, because if any question is there, then they will write on the chat box.
Okay, so our next concept is cost. So what do you mean by cost? This is the main thing that a manager must be considered while taking a economic decision. What do you mean by cost? So here, why cost is important? काहीं की कॉस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट? कॉस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट बिकॉज़ कॉस्ट ऊपर तो सब जिन डिपेंड करे। जदि तुम पाखे लिमिट नहीं, जदि तुम पाखे पैसा नहीं, देन हाउ कैन यू डिसाइड दैट व्हाट टू डू, हाउ टू परचेज, हाउ टू टेक अ डिसीजन। सिमिलरली ए मैनेजर, ऑन द पार्ट ऑफ अ मैनेजर, कॉस्ट इज एन इम्पोर्टेंट बिकॉज ही विल टेक अ रैशनल डिसीजन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द कॉस्ट ओनली। सो हियर according to cost analysis, or on the basis of the cost analysis, manager will take two important decision: whether to produce or not, or if produce, then how much to produce. If produce, then how much to produce. So here the meaning of cost is nothing but it is the cost of production that refers to the expenditure incurred on buying of inputs for producing a given level of output. गोटे level of output produce करिबा पई जते बेले गोटे farm जो जो factor inputs hire करे किंबा buy करे, ता पछरी जहा expenditure, जहा जहा जो जो head रे जो जो expenditure incurred हुए, that when we combine all the expenditures incurred on all different heads of input, then such cost representing as total cost or the cost of production. Then we move to types of cost. First, here we discuss that fixed cost and variable cost. So what is fixed cost? Fixed cost are those costs which do not change. When output is increased or decreased, the cost do not change. They have to be incurred whether the output is large, small, or even zero. जेते बड़े गोटे business start हुए, तो सेतेबेले गोटे सेटअप निया हुए, फर्स्ट कौन प्रोडक्शन प्रोसेस रे रेडी ही जाए नाई, फर्स्ट गोटे सेटअप निया हुए, फर्स्ट लैंड निया हुए, देन मशीनरी परचेज करा हुए, ता परे वेरिएबल फैक्टर इंक्लूड कला परे, देन ओनली वी एंटर इनटू द प्रोसेस ऑफ प्रोडक्शन। तो जो पर्यंत प्रोडक्शन हेनी से पर्यंत भी जदि लैंड नियागला, जदि मशीनरी नियागला, तो से जो लैंड नियाला कि बिल्डिंग प्रिमाइसेस नियागला, ता ऊपर किछि गोटे रेंट दिया जाउची, इट मींस आउटपुट प्रोडक्शन न हेले भी ता ऊपर कॉस्ट इनकर होउची, एक्सपेंडिचर होउची। सो हियर दैट्स व्हाई इट इज मेंशनड हियर दैट फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट आर दोस कॉस्ट which do not change when output is increased or decreased or even zero. जेतेबले output zero भी था है, सेतेबले भी fixed cost को incur करा जाए. For example, rent of land, interest on machinery, salary of permanent employees, etc. एबे for example जन्ती lockdown हिला, बहुत टे institution बंद थिला, but सेठी जो permanent employees थिले, से मानुको salary paid करा हो थिला की नहीं. So that is we called as fixed cost. Because without any production activity, they incur the cost. So, fixed cost are the cost which do not change when output is increased or decreased. Then variable cost. Variable cost are those cost which changes with changes in output. Jetebele level of output ko amko increase karibar achi. To setire jo raw material darkar. Raw material badhebaku padibo to ta jodi raw material increase hola to ta pachare expenses bhi increase hobo. Raw material besides raw material to if we employ more amount of or more units of labor then also wages increases. So that is also a variable cost. So variable cost are the cost which changes with the changes in output. Jodi ame output decision nou je ki amko output increase karibar achi ki output decrease karibar achi to ta pachare jo jo expenses ase like on raw materials like on labors, so all these are considered as variable cost. Then the next is actual cost and opportunity cost. So actual costs are nothing but these are those costs which a firm incurs while producing a good. Gote good production re kimba gote product jete bele produce hue sete bele gote farm se production ra se product ra production lagi jo jo inputs use heitai land ho ki raw materials ho ki entrepreneurship ho ki electricity ho ki wages ho jaha kichi bhi jaha jaha cost incur hochi kimba jo jo expenditure incur hochi all those costs are known as actual cost or otherwise known as outlay cost or acquisition cost, means the total cost. Then the another concept, this on the contrary to actual cost, there is opportunity cost. So what is this opportunity cost? Opportunity cost is nothing but the next best alternative that could be produced, next best alternative that foregone. Next best alternative mane kon? Next best alternative, it means what? It means that suppose gote manager achi, suppose gote manager achi jie ki jodi factory A re manager hisab re employment na pai thanta, then फैक्ट्री बी रे थांदा और फैक्ट्री बी रे थिले से जो सैलरी पाई थांदा से सैलरी टा जदी से फैक्ट्री ए रे पाउनी देन दैट सैलरी दैट ही कुड गेन फ्रॉम फार्म बी इज द नेक्स्ट बेस्ट अल्टरनेटिव दैट फॉरगोन इज द अपॉर्चुनिटी कॉस्ट. इट मींस अपॉर्चुनिटी कॉस्ट इज द नेक्स्ट बेस्ट अल्टरनेटिव दैट कुड बी प्रोड्यूस्ड इंस्टेड बाय द सेम फैक्टर्स कॉस्टिंग सेम अमाउंट ऑफ मनी एंड दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी कॉस्ट इज अदरवाइज नोन एज द अपॉर्चुनिटी कॉस्ट इज अदरवाइज नोन एज अल्टरनेटिव कॉस्ट और ट्रांसफर अर्निंग्स. अल्टरनेटिव कॉस्ट और ट्रांसफर अर्निंग्स. सो आई थिंक दिस टू कॉन्सेप्ट्स आर क्लियर टू ऑल. That is opportunity cost and actual cost. Then the next one is explicit cost and implicit cost. So what is this explicit cost? Here explicit cost refers to actual money expenditure of a business enterprise in purchasing or hiring the services of factors. It means in other words we can say this explicit cost is quite similar to the actual cost, means what are the money expenditure that of business enterprise or a firm incurred in hiring or purchasing or buying the services of factors. For example, laborers, raw materials, insurance, electricity, etc. What are the expenditures incurred by a firm or by a production factory or by a business enterprise while hiring the services of factors to produce a particular amount of output or particular level of product. Explicit cost are also known as accounting cost. Explicit costs are also known as accounting cost. It means accounting cost is the other name of explicit cost. Then, contrary to this explicit cost, there is other cost, that is implicit cost. Implicit cost represents value of foregone opportunity but do not involve any actual payment. Implicit cost mane kono? Suppose gote business ro gote business gote, suppose if an individual starts a business by acting as a manager, so CA jetebele tara nijoro own business start karuchi aa sethire nije manager hisab re kaam karuchi taku kono salary diya jae ki taku salary diya jae ni. So what jodi si jodi au kono si jaga re as a manager employment paithanda to salary paithanda, but jehetu eta ta nijoro employment nijoro business, so sethi pai si kichi particularly salary kichi pauni. It means that cost which is not accountable or which is not included in the accounts, that is known as implicit cost. It means implicit cost represents value of foregone opportunities. Implicit cost represents the value of foregone opportunities. Implicit cost ku aute where bhi ame explain kari pariba. Suppose gote ओनर जदि निजर कैपिटल इन्वेस्ट करुची निजर बिजनेस रे, सो सी जो कैपिटल इन्वेस्ट करुची तार रिवार्ड रे ताको कोनो इंटरेस्ट मिलुची की, सो दैट अमाउंट और दैट कॉस्ट व्हिच द ओनर हिमसेल्फ बेयर्स, दैट इज नोन एज इम्प्लिसिट कॉस्ट. सो द ओनर सप्लाइड हिज ओन कैपिटल टू द एंटरप्राइज एंड द इंटरेस्ट दैट ही वुड हैव अर्नड देयरफॉर हैड ही लेंट द कैपिटल टू अदर्स, सेटा इंक्लूड होनी सेथिपई सेटा को इम्प्लिसिट कॉस्ट कुआ जाए. बट जोटा अकाउंटिंग सेंस रे आउटसाइडर्स को दिया होची आउ अकाउंटिंग अकाउंट रे इंक्लूड करा जाउची, दैट इज नोन एज एक्सप्लिसिट कॉस्ट. बट जदि गोटे बिजनेस ओनर निजे निजर कैपिटल तार ओन बिजनेस रे इन्वेस्ट करुची, देन दैट कॉस्ट वुड रिप्रेजेंटेड एज इम्प्लिसिट कॉस्ट. देन द नेक्स्ट इज अकाउंटिंग एंड इकोनॉमिक कॉस्ट. So what is this accounting and economic cost? These two terms come from two group of people, that is one is accountant. Accounting cost comes from the side of accountants and economic cost comes from the side of the economists. So what accountants concerned? The accountants concerned with the financial statement of the firm in terms of assets and liabilities. Why they are maintaining such a financial statement, asset and liabilities? In order to evaluate the past performance as well as calculating the profit and loss of the firm. Sethipai semane asset or liability financial statement accountants maintain karanti in order to calculate the profit or loss of the firm. It means they include the explicit cost, but the accountant does not think about the implicit costs. What about the implicit cost? Here economists, the persons, they are concerned with what cost is expected to be in the future and how the firm might be able to rearrange its resources to lower its cost and improve profitability. Such costs are known as economic cost or future cost. It means accountants simane khali एक्सप्लिसिट कॉस्ट को इंक्लूड करती इन ऑर्डर टू मेंटेन द फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट ऑफ द फर्म टू इवैल्यूएट पास्ट परफॉर्मेंस एज वेल एज कैलकुलेटिंग द प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस लॉस ऑफ द फर्म. बट इकोनॉमिस्ट दे कंसिडर बोथ द कॉस्ट, एक्सप्लिसिट कॉस्ट एज वेल एज द इम्प्लिसिट कॉस्ट, एंड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ बोथ दे कैलकुलेट और दे जस्ट एक्सपेक्ट दैट वट वुड बी द फ्यूचर कॉस्ट एंड वट वुड बी द इकोनॉमिक कॉस्ट इन फ्यूचर. सो दिस इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू. इन द अकाउंटिंग कॉस्ट ओनली एक्सप्लिसिट कॉस्ट इज इंक्लूडेड, बट इन द इकोनॉमिक कॉस्ट एक्सप्लिसिट इम्प्लिसिट एंड ऑल्सो अपॉर्चुनिटी कॉस्ट इज इंक्लूडेड. देन द नेक्स्ट कॉस्ट कॉन्सेप्ट इज कंट्रोलेबल एंड नॉन कंट्रोलेबल कॉस्ट. What is this controllable and non-controllable cost? So here, controllable costs are those costs which are capable of being controlled or regulated by the executive vigilance and thus maintain the executive efficiency. Controllable माने कौन जो cost को control करा जाई पारी हो. Suppose हमरो raw material रे बहुत अधिका cost माने बहुत raw material आर more expensive. So जदि raw material expensive होची ता माने product भी expensive ही होबो. Cost of production जेहेतु बढ़ूची. So इठी जो माने executive अछंदी से माने दे must try that how they will minimize the cost. So raw material को जदि कमेई दिया जीवो किंबा तार अदर किछि सब्स्टिट्यूट आमे जदि खोजि नेबा तो दैट कॉस्ट विल बी कंट्रोल्ड बट देयर आर सम कॉस्ट व्हिच आर बियॉन्ड द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव कंट्रोल और सुपरविजन एंड सच कॉस्ट आर नोन एज नॉन कंट्रोलेबल कॉस्ट. फॉर एग्जांपल गोटे मशीनरी जदि किणा हेजी गोटे मशीनरी किणा हेजी गोटे पर्टिकुलर यूज पई किंतु सेटा जदि यूज रे न भी आसीबो किंबा सेटा जदि डे बाय डे ईयर बाय ईयर जदि इंक्रीज हे जाउची तो तार डेप्रिसिएशन हबो. डेप्रिसिएशन इट मींस से जति कि यूज हबो तार नॉर्मल वेयर एंड टियर पई किछि लॉस हबो जोटा कि कंट्रोल रे नथाय एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन रो काहे कि आमे जदि गोटे जिंस किणीचे ताको यूज करू किंबा न करू डे बाय डे तार वैल्यू कमी कमी जाए बिकॉज ऑफ द नॉर्मल वेयर एंड टियर. सो दिस आर द एग्जांपल ऑफ नॉन कंट्रोलेबल कॉस्ट. देन another concept is out of pocket and book cost. So what is out of pocket cost? Out of pocket costs are those costs that improve the current cash payment to outsider. Current cash payment eti gote word current cash payment. So eti cash payment hochi cash payment kaha ko kara jae jo mane daily jo mane employees achandi kimba daily laborers achandi kimba rent land upre rent diya jauchi ki capital card jodi udharana hechi bank ru suppose udhar niya hechi to ta upre interest payment kara jauchi kimba transportation gote jagaru a gote jaga ko jodi ame product ट्रांसपोर्ट करूचु तो से आमको ट्रांसपोर्टेशन सिस्टम रो दरकार पड़ुचे एंड वी मस्ट हैव टू बेयर सम चार्जेस. सो ऑल दिस कॉस्ट इंक्लूड और इन्वॉल्व कैश पेमेंट टू आउटसाइडर्स. सो सच कॉस्ट आर नोन एज आउट ऑफ पॉकेट कॉस्ट. देन इन अदर वर्ड्स वी कैन से दिस आउट ऑफ पॉकेट कॉस्ट आर ऑल्सो नोन एज एक्सप्लिसिट कॉस्ट बिकॉज वी आर पेइंग टू आउटसाइडर्स. एंड देन अनदर concept here is that is book cost. Book cost माने कौन just opposite to explicit cost. जेमती कि मु previously example देली कि suppose जदि गोटे individual निजर own business start कला निजर capital सेथिरे invest कला किंबा निजे ही act कला as a manager then सेटा ताको कौन cash payment करा जीवो कि करा जाए नी तो सेटा कौन करा जाए that would be involve that does not involve any cash payment but there is a provision for them. There is a provision for them in terms of that will be entered in a book of account to include them in profit or loss accounts. So for example salary of the own manager interest cost of owner's own fund jodi own business re se nijara hi fund lagaila to se nijuku kono interest dabo ki na that would be made a provision ki last re jaha profit hobala ki loss hala that is the thing that would be included the owner's account but सेति पई किछि एक्स्ट्रा कैश पेमेंट दिया जाय नी. सो दैट इज नोन एज बुक कॉस्ट और इम्प्लिसिट कॉस्ट और इम्प्यूटेड कॉस्ट. सो दिस इज द टू कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ कॉस्ट. अनदर टू कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ कॉस्ट दैट इज आउट ऑफ पॉकेट कॉस्ट एंड बुक कॉस्ट. द नेक्स्ट इज पास्ट एंड फ्यूचर कॉस्ट. एज द नेम सजेस्ट पास्ट जोटा पास्ट रे इनकर्ड हेची सेटा होचे पास्ट कॉस्ट. पास्ट रे इनकर्ड हेची माने एक्चुअली सेटा हेई सारीची दैट ऑलरेडी इनकर्ड. सो सबुबले सेटा गोटे स्टेटमेंट किंबा फाइनेंशियल अकाउंट रे रेकॉर्ड हे कि थाए. सो पास्ट कॉस्ट मींस इन अदर वर्ड्स वी कैन से दैट इज द एक्चुअल कॉस्ट काहे कि सेटा हेई सारी छि ऑलरेडी. बट व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट फ्यूचर कॉस्ट आर दोस कॉस्ट दैट आर लाइकली टू बी इनकर्ड इन द फ्यूचर माने जोटा कि फ्यूचर रे हबो हेई नाही एंड we all know that future is uncertain so this cost have to be estimated mane ame estimate kariba or cannot be expected to absolutely correct kahe ki ame janine ki future re raw material ra price kete hobo future re laborers ra price kete hobo future re jodi ame kichi कोटु गोटे कैपिटल कौन सी बैंक रु जदि आमे लोन लौचे बोरो करूचे देन व्हाट वुड बी द इंटरेस्ट ऑन देम. सो देयर इज अनसर्टेनिटी इन फ्यूचर सो से कहगला कि पास्ट कॉस्ट हूँ एक्चुअल कॉस्ट बट फ्यूचर कॉस्ट जोटा से एक्सपेक्टेड कॉस्ट एंड द फिगर इज नॉट एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट फिगर ओनली वी आर प्रोजेक्टिंग अ अमाउंट ऑफ कॉस्ट सो दिस इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन पास्ट कॉस्ट एंड फ्यूचर कॉस्ट देन नेक्स्ट वन इज sunk cost and incremental cost. So sunk cost is what do you mean by sunk cost? Here sunk cost represent the expenditure that have been made in the past and must be paid in future as a part of contractual aggregate agreement or previous decision. For example, suppose 4 वर्ष कि 5 वर्ष आगुरु गोटे बिजनेस स्टार्ट होची एंड द ओनर ऑफ दैट बिजनेस जस्ट डू एन एग्रीमेंट विथ सम अदर पार्टी और फॉर लैंड से लैंड लीज रे नेला तो सेतेबेले जेतेबेले एग्रीमेंट हेइथिला सेतेबेले भी से पेमेंट करूची एंड जेते पर्यंत तार बिजनेस कंटिन्यू करूची सेते पर्यंत से सेटाकु पेड करूथुबो पे करूथुबो टिल द बिजनेस विल कंटिन्यू सो संक कॉस्ट आर द एक्सपेंडिचर्स दैट हैव बीन मेड इन द पास्ट एंड मस्ट बी पेड इन द फ्यूचर अकॉर्डिंग टू द contractual agreement or previous decision. So example is that money already paid for machinery or equipment or future rental payments on a warehouse that must be paid for as a part of long-term lease agreement are sunk cost. But when a manager taking an economic decision, then there is no relevance of this sunk cost. Sunk costs are also known as non-avoidable or non-escapable कॉस्ट व्हाई इट इज नॉन अवॉइडेबल और नॉन एस्केपेबल कहीं जदि गोटे एग्रीमेंट पास्ट रे ही सारी यू आर बाउंड टू पे दैट अमाउंट इन फ्यूचर ऑल्सो और जेपर्यंत तुम बिजनेस कंटिन्यू करुची से पर्यंत द मैनेजर और द ओनर विल बाउंड टू पे दैट कॉस्ट और बेयर दैट कॉस्ट सो दैट्स व्हाई संक कॉस्ट आर नॉन अवॉइडेबल एंड नॉन एस्केपेबल कॉस्ट देन Contrary to this, the other concept is incremental cost. Incremental cost refers to total additional cost of implementing a managerial decision. So, ethi total additional cost mane kono? Jodi managerial decision change hela, if the manager changes decision in terms of increasing the level of output or replacing the machinery which is used before or earlier, so replacing the machinery, to sete bole kono hobo? Sete bole cost of प्रोडक्शन किंबा कॉस्ट इनकर्मेंट किंबा कॉस्ट एक्सपेंडिचर ऑफ द फार्म इंक्रीज करिबो किंबा डिक्रीज करिबो अकॉर्डिंग टू द मैनेजरियल डिसीजन सो एठी जो जिनसोटा डिपेंड करूची मैनेजर रो डिसीजन उपरे एंड दैट लीड टू एडिशनल कॉस्ट दैट इज नोन एज इंक्रीमेंटल कॉस्ट सपोज जदि आउटपुट लेवल को इंक्रीज करिवार अछि कि गोटे मशीनरी को रिप्लेस करिवार अछि देन इट नीड सम कॉस्ट और इट इनकर सम कॉस्ट एंड सच अ कॉस्ट इज नोन एज इंक्रीमेंटल कॉस्ट Then the next is direct cost and indirect cost. What is this direct cost and indirect cost? As the name suggests, the direct cost are the cost which involve directly in the production activity. Directly in the production activity, suppose aluminium production re raw alumina darkar, labor darkar. तो से गुड़ाक है डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट से जो एक्सपेंडिचर इनकर हो बाय द फार्म दैट इज नोन एज डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट बट टू रन दैट एल्युमिनियम फैक्ट्री और एल्युमिनियम प्रोडक्शन हाउस देर आर सम अदर कॉस्ट दैट आर नॉट डायरेक्टली रिलेटेड टू दैट प्रोडक्शन प्रोसेस फॉर एग्जांपल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन अच्छी एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव ऑफिस अच्छी जो थे एम्प्लॉइज अच्छा से सैलरीज पे करने को पड़ू फॉर दैट बिल्डिंग इलेक्ट्रिसिटी चार्जेस अच्छी डेप्रिसिएशन ऑफ प्लांट अच्छी बिल्डिंग अच्छी तो यही कॉस्ट गुड़ाक डायरेक्टली प्रोडक्शन एक्टिविटी रे इन्वॉल्व ना एल्युमिनियम प्रोडक्शन करिवारे इलेक्ट्रिसिटी चार्जेस कि ऑफिस रे जो एम्प्लॉय माने बसुचंदी मीन्स फाइनेंशियल अकाउंट देखुचंदी कि एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव अकाउंट देखुचंदी कि लॉ पार्ट देखुचंदी तो से माने डायरेक्टली प्रोडक्शन एक्टिविटी रे इन्वॉल्व नहांती दैट्स व्हाई ऑल दिस कॉस्ट आर रिलेटेड टू द प्रोडक्शन प्रोसेस बट नॉट डायरेक्टली इन्वॉल्व इनटू द प्रोडक्शन एक्टिविटी दैट्स व्हाई All these costs are known as indirect cost. Okay, then the next concept is separable and common cost. Separable and common cost. Here, separable cost are what cost? So the cost that can be easily attributed to a particular product, to a particular process or to a particular head or to a particular division, such costs are known as separable costs. But common costs are those costs which cannot be traced to any separate unit or any one unit of operation. So it can better be understood with the help of an example. For example, in an university, there is VC, faculties, and other staff members. So the salary of VC is not separable according to department wise. VC to samastanka upare kaam karanti. Different departments achi. Science achi, history achi, commerce achi, political science achi. But say jone VC hi sabu jinsa ku administer karuchanti. But according to department wise, tanka salary ta separable nuhe. Kintu, but the salary of the teachers corresponding to the different department are separable. How? Jodi jone professor achi, ta salary alaga. Jone assistant professor achi, ta salary alaga. Jodi jone only lecturer achi, then tar salary alaga. And according to department wise, different stream wise, salaries alaga. So here, separable cost are the cost that is attributed to a particular head, to a particular division, but common cost are such cost which cannot be traced to any unit of operation. Jodi ame production ro gote example nova, tale koi pariba, jemti ki electricity. Kete labor, jodi ame 10 unit of labor employ koruche gote output production re, to per unit labor se x quantity of output kete produce koruche. आमे सेपरेट करी पारिबा जे से पर यूनिट ऑफ आउटपुट रो कॉस्ट केते किंतु इलेक्ट्रिसिटी पर यूनिट आउटपुट केते पडु छी कामे कोन कहि पारिबानी से कॉस्ट कहि पारिम बिकॉज़ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इज कॉमन इलेक्ट्रिसिटी प्लांट रे यूज होउ छी इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव ऑफिस रे यूज होउ छी इलेक्ट्रिसिटी सेटी कर जो कैंटीन थिबो से कैंटीन रे भी यूज होउ छी सो some costs are there which cannot be separable to a particular division or to a particular product. So such costs are known as common cost. Then total cost, average cost, and marginal cost. So total cost, as it is nothing new, total cost of a firm is the total sum total of all the explicit and implicit expenditures incurred for producing a given level of output. And as I explained earlier in the first slide of cost concept, that fixed cost and variable cost. So in other words, we can say that total cost is nothing but the combination of fixed cost and variable cost. Okay, but the next or the another concept is that is average cost. Average cost is the cost per unit of output. Gote unit output production pachare kete cost poduchi. That is the average cost, and it is found by dividing total cost by the level of output. Total jetiki cost poduchi, jodi total amount of output setre divide kale tale ame jani pariba ki gote unit output production re kete cost poduchi. And marginal cost refers to jodi gote unit output change hela tale total cost re kete changes hochi. For example, jodi 20 units of output production hochi आ मु जदि 1 यूनिट ऑफ आउटपुट मोर प्रोड्यूस करबा को चाहे बी मींस 21 यूनिट्स देन व्हाट इज द चेंज इन द टोटल कॉस्ट ऑफ प्रोडक्शन दैट इज नोन एज द मार्जिनल कॉस्ट दैट इज नोन एज द मार्जिनल कॉस्ट सो द नेक्स्ट कांसेप्ट इज शॉर्ट रन कॉस्ट एंड शॉर्ट रन कॉस्ट So short run cost is what? Short run cost are the costs over a period during which some factors of production are fixed. Some factors of production are fixed, and under short run we consider three concepts: total fixed cost, total variable cost, and the combination of the two is known as the total cost. Where variable cost are those costs which the manager can control or alter in the short run by changing the level of output, but fixed cost are those cost which are the beyond the control of the manager. Kahin ki fixed cost output production no hele bhi bear kariba ku pade or pay kariba ku pade, but variable cost it depends on the variable factor such as raw materials, such as labors. So according to the level of production or by changing the level of production, we can change, the manager can change the variable cost. So these are all about the cost concepts. So all these about the types of cost or cost concepts. Now, if any doubt, so dear learners, you can ask question in the chat box. Hello, is there any doubt?
I request all the learners, please write down your doubts on the chat box. From any of the concept regarding production, inputs, outputs, fixed factors, variable factors, production function, the various concepts of production function, various laws of production function, isoquant, ISO cost, ridgeline, economic region, and any of the cost concept. If you have any doubts, please write down on the chat box. Okay, ma'am, so we had a very very thorough discussion throughout about the production and inputs, which is a very important concept in the entire process of production. And it is very clear now about what is fixed factor and what is variable factors and what are the various types of costs that are incurred. For farms and managers, it is very important to minimize the cost of production and maximize the output. And for that reason, it is important to know what is production and what are the various costs. So with this, if there are any doubts, please ask. Amit sir says, thanks, madam, for this wonderful session.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
So
thank you so much, ma'am, for having a class with
thank
us.
You. Thank you.
Thank you from all the learners.
Thank you.
Hello, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Can we officially close the meeting now?
Yes.
Thank you, sir.